Tiana Alba has one more assignment before she's graduated by a unique high school in San Francisco's working class Excelsior neighborhood.
That's how I wanted to start it off. Hello, my name is Tiana Alba, and I am a senior here at City Arts and Technology. Today, I will be presenting my graduation portfolio defense. Today, I will be defending three artifacts.
Tiana will defend her academic performance in a make-or-break presentation before teachers who, as often as not, decline to graduate their students until they can agree their student has done the work they need to be truly ready to graduate.
The graduation portfolio is really a culmination of students' 4 years at City Arts and Tech, and it's a chance for them to be able to defend it in front of a panel of teachers, students, family members, community members, and they come up with a presentation that proves that they're ready for college-level work.
Facing these challenges and overcoming them means that I've become stronger as a student.
Nerve-wracking, the graduation defense is part of this school's innovative project-based approach to deeper learning. Schools like City Arts and Technology that support deeper learning prepare students not only to know and understand core academic content, but also place equal importance on developing a student's ability to think critically, work collaboratively, communicate effectively, and be self-directed in the learning process.
At Envision Schools and at City Arts and Tech High School, we feel that the best measure of our success, the way that we look and analyze ourselves, is based on whether students are graduating from college. And so last year, 100% of our students went on to college. And based on the data that we have for our graduating classes so far, 93% are persisting in college.
Caleb Lawson has just a few more finals before he graduates from St. Mary's, a liberal arts college north of Oakland, California.
As far as a four-year university goes, I'm the first to actually like go right after high school straight to a four-year university and finish on time too, which is really, it's a big deal for our family. I never thought that I was going to go to college in high school. That just wasn't something that we talked about in my house. That's kind of a scary thought to think about. Where would I be without Envision? I don't know. I think I would still be lost. I wouldn't have had the mentors that I've had to kind of push me. I certainly wouldn't have had the long-term goals I have. I don't think I would have the motivation to have a career for myself or like a really big end goal for myself.
That culture of academic success is what drew Tiana to transfer to an Envision school.
All of my brothers and sisters dropped out somehow after 10th grade. And, you know, to be honest, I was going to end up just like the rest of them. Within a matter of a few months of being a cat and interacting with all the students and the teachers and learning one-on-one and having that encouragement and recognition that I really needed, I was able to prove to myself that I was smart and that I did have, you know, the tools to do it given to me.
The academic rigor at schools like City Arts and Technology goes hand in hand with strong supports for both teachers and students. There is intense collaboration among students and teachers here and a high level of personalization. Everyone has a stake in preparing students for college and career.
And you know, what are the steps of scientific method?
It is initial question.
Yeah, write this down just so you have it.
Oh, no, I have it right here.
Perfect.
Initial question, research, hypothesize, conduct an experiment, get results, and concluding answer or concluding result.
Teachers come to us because what we do here resonates with the reasons why they went into teaching. They come to our schools because they care about kids. And they care about teaching kids in addition to teaching their subject matter. It is a culture that we've created that we are all about supporting students and being successful and graduating from college.
The approach to learning that we use here at City Arts and Tech is really getting the kids to be able to apply what they're learning.
Its rate is 15 what?
Feet per second.
The really super amazing technical dive is a pre-calc project that I've created, and it involves a Ferris wheel, a timer, and a tub of water that moves. I set myself in the problem, and so I'm going around on a Ferris wheel, and there's a moving cart of water that's on a track underneath the Ferris wheel. The students are asked to calculate at what time I'm supposed to jump off the Ferris wheel in order to land in the tub of water safely. The kids really like this kind of project because it's not direct instruction. It's not me standing up in front of the classroom. It's me as the guide helping them figure out, okay, what do we really need? Do we need to think about, you know, wind resistance? So it gets them thinking real world about this situation.
If you look at what the expectations are in college and then career, students are expected to do more than just to be able to recall information. They're going to have to be effective problem solvers, critical thinkers, and so everything that we do at Envision Schools is mapped backwards from that. For us, the call for deeper learning is really about our students having success after they leave us.
This kind of learning is hard work for students like Tiana, but the number of schools engaged in this kind of deeper learning is growing across the U.S. Deeper learning requires students to develop the core knowledge and essential abilities they will need to compete in the world economy. Hundreds of other schools nationwide are also engaging in deeper learning, each unique in their approach, but focused on the same goal of graduating students that are truly ready for college and career.
When students come back to CAT after they've been at college and I ask them, were you prepared? And they say, well, what really prepared us was that graduation portfolio. All of that writing and all of the revision and asking us to do such high quality work, that prepared us.
We talk about three things that students have to do. They need to be able to master knowledge. Our current assessments do a pretty good job for us to learn what our kids know. But what they're not doing is asking our kids to demonstrate what they can do, to apply their knowledge, to demonstrate their understanding. Envision School serves a really diverse group of students, and about 70% of our students will be the first in their family to go to college. I believe that all students, especially those students who are going to be the first in their family to go to college, deserve to have the same educational opportunities to do deeper learning, not just surface learning.
I finished the revisions for the oil spill lab that you gave me earlier. So I think everything should be done in terms of that. To be quite honest, this has been the hardest thing I've had to do my high school career. The graduation portfolio defense process has really taken a toll on me, in a good way though, not in a bad way. This is an amazing process that I feel that every student needs to experience.
We believe that by preparing our students to go to and graduate from college, it's the best hope for us to end the cycle of poverty for those students and their families, and the research bears that out. We also think it's the best hope for our democracy. The more students that we can graduate from high school who go to college and become productive members of our economy, but are also really deep critical thinkers, the better we are off as a country.
Tiana?
Yes.
Congratulations, you're fast.
I will be the first generation student to graduate from my family. So that's a huge accomplishment. I got into 4 colleges, 4 out of the 6 colleges that I applied to. I'm gonna live on campus at Sonoma, and I actually want to major in teaching. You know, and I have CAT and all of my supporters to thank for that.
What do you want to do in
College? I forget.
Teach.
Yes.
You guys got through to me.